Hey aspiring chemist, today we'll be making some copper hydroxide, a beautiful blue compound that you can create at home. It's used as a fungicide and is a byproduct of many reactions, but it's also an essential material for preparing the Schweizer's reagent, a reagent capable of dissolving cellulose. And guess what? I'll be making a video on that very soon, so if you don't want to miss that video, make sure you subscribe and hit that notification bell. Before we get there, let's talk about the materials you need for today's experiment. And they are some copper electrodes, a DC power supply, and a plastic container. First, we take a beaker and add about 200 ml of water and dissolve a spoonful of sodium chloride. This acts as the catalyst for the electrolysis. Next, we sand our electrodes to remove the oxide layer that has formed on it. Using a copper plate would be better for the anode as it has increased surface area, but because I don't have a copper plate available, I twisted one of my copper electrodes into a spiral to increase the surface area that comes in contact with the water. We connect our electrodes to the DC power supply, add our salt solution, and turn on the power. The electrolysis begins with hydrogen formed at our cathode and the hydroxide formed at the anode. It is important to stir the solution every once in a while to prevent the hydroxide from building up on the electrodes. About 30 minutes later, something unexpected happened. A yellow compound begins to form. Well, I did some research and realized that this was copper 1 oxide formed from the unstable copper 1 hydroxide. This was as a result of the high current I used, so I removed the solution, added a fresh batch, and reduced the current from 1 amps to 0.5 amps. An hour later, the solution becomes brilliant blue. Now we are forming the copper 2 hydroxide. So all we have to do is to be patient so that we increase the yield of the copper hydroxide we get. The electrolysis ran for about 2 days and my first anode was corroded completely, so I had to replace it. As you can see, the copper hydroxide has taken a dark color and a lot of it has settled. This tells us that we have a good concentration of fine precipitate. The reaction is done. We disassemble the setup. Then we decant the clear liquid. Wash the solution to get rid of any sodium chloride. And decant it once more. Once that's done, we transfer it to an evaporation dish. Within a day, it dries and we extract the precipitate. The amount of copper hydroxide is smaller than I expected, but this proves that the method works. If you need a larger quantity for your project, feel free to run the exact setup over and over. We have successfully turned copper metal into a valuable chemical using just salt and electricity. If you have ideas for another everyday chemical that we can make from scratch, drop your suggestions in the comment section. Don't forget to hit the subscribe and join the experiment. I can't wait to see you in the next one.